I'm busy.
Yeah, so am I. Where's Sonny?
I don't know.
What'd he tell you about shooting Johnny?
Nothing.
Come on, Jason. Sonny tells you everything. He tells you the actual truth, not the little crap he serves up for the rest of us.
I haven't spoken with Sonny. There hasn't been time. When he decided to jump bail, I was getting ambushed by Santos Lopez and his men. But I'll tell you what I do know. Sonny's not stupid. He's not going to walk up to Johnny on a public street and open fire.
Okay. Then prove it.
Well, this is a nice surprise.
Yeah, well, it's always good to see my baby sister. I was actually hoping to catch Dante.
He's actually out investigating Johnny's shooting and Sonny's bail jump, but you're stuck with me, if that's good enough.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good enough. I just, I don't know if you're gonna like hearing what I have to say.
Really? Well, then I think that's all the more reason to sit down and tell me.
Okay, well, I went to question Johnny, and I got about what I expected, you know, the party line. He says he was unarmed and that Sonny shot him in cold blood.
And you don't believe him?
Well, there's a big piece missing out of that day, and if I could find that piece, we might know what actually happened. But...
Okay, so what's, unexpected?
Well, when I was talking to Johnny, he suggested that I quit the force and start working for him.
What?
Yeah, I know. It's ridiculous. But, you know, the strange thing was there was a small part of me that almost wanted to say yes.
I know that you're restless, but considering working for Johnny...
I'm not considering it. I just...
Well, I just don't think that you would be talking about it if you weren't thinking seriously about it. What is this? Does this have to do with Elizabeth's situation?
I'm restless, okay? Just like you said. And I don't know if it has anything to do with Elizabeth. Maybe it does. I mean, she took the boys to Northern California to see Sarah... And when Cam and Jake aren't around, I don't have to be responsible. So yeah, maybe that's messing with my head a little bit. But this whole cop thing is just not working for me right now.
You never were one to follow rules.
You know, and the bad guys, speaking of rules, with all their fancy lawyers, they just get to dance around them anyway. And the good guys, we get stuck coloring inside the lines, and it's frustrating. I keep hearing Dad in my head over and over again. Asking, what the hell were you thinking?
I didn't know you were this disillusioned. I think the question is exactly how disillusioned.
I'm not gonna go join a criminal organization, okay? But if I'm being honest, I'm a little envious of Johnny and Sonny sometimes.
What? I think that you're better than both of them.
I'm not envious of the darkness they have to live in day in and day out, but there's just, you know, there's a certain, I don't know, rhythm and creativity to being an outlaw. And I used to be a version of that. You know, Dad and I used to run our scams and do our thing. It was a rush. And now, I don't know. I was just, you know, we would only stick it to marks that deserved it. It was like justice was being served, but in a way I can't accomplish anymore. It's like poetic justice or something.
So what are you gonna do?
I don't know. I'm probably just venting. But if I figure something out, I will let you know.
Why is it suddenly on me to prove Sonny's guilt or innocence?
Everything I've got tells me that Sonny's lying. Look, I have to operate under certain constraints, but you have no limits, okay? And you got Spinelli. Get him on this case. Find a gun. Find a witness. Give me something I can use to exonerate Sonny.
I can't tell you how crazy it makes me knowing Sonny is off.
Sonny's off the hook.